Wale ambao tulifika mapema tulipata chakula cha mchana. Tuwaelekeze tu kulingana. Najua ulitoka asubuhi na mapema kwenda kutuletea shule. Mama Rex, tutulie ili tuanze rasmi. Comrade, tutulie. Oya.
Na tumekuja kwa mazishi ya Rex. Naomba jezi majezi niwape tafadhali. Ile chini. Sifuna sekretari anasema tukae chini. Na wameona gavana pia ameingia. Na venye alisimama na sisi tukae chini.
Naomba tafadhali pale kwa mlango tufungue hiyo familia. Naomba tu. Naomba
chika.
Rex, tafadhali kuria. Kuweka bendera yetu ya Kenya.
On my avenue, and someone had been shot. I've never been to a protest where someone has died. Uniformed with their shell shot with your husband Chris, and I have no words. Your son died a hero. I know it's a heavy price to pay for a mother and a father, but you have to lose your son for Kenya to be liberated from.
naomba ufungue hapa ili tuendelee. Hatupigani na serikali, tunasema tu ukweli venye vitu ziko. Tunasema tu ukweli. We are just saying the truth as ministers of the gospel. Yesterday niliona imepostiwa YouTube that a youthful pastor is sending a message to President Ruto demanding for justice for Rex. Fine, I may be a youthful pastor, but why am I speaking this way? I'm speaking this way because our fathers that brought the president to us are now quiet. They are now quiet when the country is sinking. They are the ones who brought the president to us and told us that we vote him in. Now, when Rex is dead, they are not saying anything. When there is corruption, they are not saying anything. That is why, as a youthful pastor, I just have to speak. And I've spoken. The officer that killed Rex is known. He's on CCTV camera. Justice be done.
That you have breathed through my soul. Your laughter, so vibrant and contagious, illuminated even the darkest of days. You bring joy into the fabric of our memories. Your wisdom, profound and reassuring, was a beacon that guided me through uncertainty, shaping the very core of who I am. You are not merely my brother, you are my hero. Your courage knew no bounds, a testament to unwavering spirit that faced challenges head-on, never faltering in the face of adversity. Your selflessness was a rare gift, always putting others before yourself, a trait that touched countless lives and left an indelible mark on all who were fortunate enough to know you. Your determination was a force of nature, a relentless pursuit of excellence and justice that inspired me each day. You sacrificed everything without hesitation to shield others from harm, embodying the true essence of bravery. Your actions spoke volumes, echoing a profound commitment to protect and uplift those around you. The void left by your absence is vast, yet amid the sorrow, I find solace in the immeasurable pride I feel to call you my brother. Your legacy, etched in bravery and compassion, will forever endure, a guiding light that illuminates my path through life's trials. Your courage continues to inspire me, a constant reminder to embrace challenges with fortitude and grace. Though the ache of missing you is profound, I find comfort in the knowledge that your love transcends time and space. Until the moment we reunite, I carry a memory in my heart, a cherished beacon of hope and love. Rest peacefully, dear brother, knowing your life was a testament to love, courage, and impact of a truly remarkable soul. Justice for Rex.
I'm not going to protest when someone has died. In the family, they are sure shot with the husband Chris, and I have no words. Your son died a hero. I know it's a heavy price to pay for a mother and a father, but you have to lose your son for Kenya to be liberated from terror and dictatorship and plunder. But because of your son's sacrifice,
and 40 years of dying, things has changed forever. So, I want you to see us as your sons. We shall come and visit. We shall come and support your family from now continuing. And rest never forgotten. His legacy will not be forgotten. I'm a father to three kids, and I can't imagine marrying a child. So to grieve is very heavy. But just know this, things has changed because of Rex. He was the first one to die during the peaceful protest. And Kenya will never be the same again because of his sacrifice. And to every young Gen Z in this room, do not be compromised. Do not be sell out. Keep demanding for a better. There's something you say, but I don't want to go away. Don't go down. The demands you're making are sensible. And if they ask you who is our leader for this movement, it's the Kenyan Constitution. Every single thing you're demanding as young people of this country, this is the Constitution. So tell Ruto and his government, he's not doing us a favor when he responds to our demands, because the Constitution of this country, it gives us a right to demand those things. Rex died a hero. And we demand justice for Rex.
Sorry that your mom has to live with this pain forever. We're sorry that we're writing this to you now. And we're sorry that you had to be the victim that Kenya and the whole world will use to define what injustice means. You said one day you'd be famous. You didn't tell us it was going to be this way. But till we meet again, our dearest cousin, thank you. Thank you for being our cousin. Thank you for being our friend. Thank you for being funny and cheeky and the slowest eater in this room. Thank you for being annoying at times and for your never-ending stories. We're going to miss you.
Thank you.
And we love you, Rex. Thank you very much. Mini cousin ya Rex. And naturally, leo kila mtu amekuja hapa because mna feel pain. For me as a cousin, at this particular moment, nataka kuhumanize. Chenye nasema ni, nataka kuwasomea speech. Enye tulimuandikia as cousins. And you see tunakumbuka venye alikuwa before this tragic a thing happened, okay? So, to my dearest cousin Rex, we are sorry that you had to go like this. We are sorry that you had to be the victim of all this calamity. We are sorry you had to be at the demonstrations in the first place. Your country failed you. We are sorry that the police treated you badly until the last minute. The police failed you. We are sorry that they abused you and wish that is in you wanted. Kina mtoko poa?
Me, I have to read the tribute from Alicia to Rex. In quiet moments, your presence is a legacy, my dear brother. Your laughter, your wisdom, and your kindness shapes my mind, my world. You are not just a brother, but also a my hero. Your courage, your selflessness, your determination inspires me every day of my life. You sacrifice everything to protect others. Your bravery will ever be intact in my heart. I will miss you deeply, but I'm also proud to call you my brother from Alicia.
Our modern day Mau Mau, and his blood did not spill in vain. His blood will water the tree of democracy, civil liberties, and human rights in this country.
Ta haki ya Rex. Huyo askari alikuwa na mkubwa wake. Kuna jamaa kule Nairobi ambaye ni kamanda wa polisi anaitwa Bungei. Bungei kwa miaka miwili ambayo imepita ameua watu zaidi ya 200 katika kaunti ya Nairobi. Tunataka huyo kamanda wa polisi anaitwa Adamson Bungei na yeye ajikute kizimbani akijibu mashtaka kwa ajili ya damu ya watu kama Rex. Huyo Adamson Bungei na yeye ana mkubwa wake ambaye ni Inspector General wa polisi. Bwana Koome, na wewe pia lazima haki ikufikie, uende mahakamani na wewe ufungwe. Huyo Inspector General wa polisi na yeye ana mkubwa wake anaitwa Kindiki. Kila siku akisimama ni kutisha wananchi na kuambia polisi waue wananchi jinsi ambavyo waliua Rex. Tunataka na Kindiki na yeye, kama kutapatikana haki ya Rex, Kindiki lazima na yeye pia haki imfikie. Na huyo Kindiki ana mkubwa wake. Mnamjua? Mnajua mkubwa wa Kindiki? Kama tunasema justice for Rex, lazima Ruto must. Lazima Ruto must. Mimi
I want to remind you Ruto that instead of pursuing your selfish political ambition on express, you should come here and let us have a conversation by the grave of Rex. We don't need to have a conversation with you on the express. We want to converse with you by the graveside. Rex died fighting for our nation. Other Kenyans died. Other Gen Zs died fighting to liberate this nation. Because the cost of education is high. Because if you go to our hospitals, there's no medicine. Because our farmers, our children are going without food, are going hungry, are hungry in this nation because there is no food. Because you are selling fake fertilizers to our farmers. And to your surprise, they are even selling, they even supplied us the money which was meant for tear gas. They ate it. They supplied us with fake tear gas, and that tear gas even caused harm to a police officer and made that police officer lose both his arms because of the money that you ate.
Akanukuliwa jana kwa runinga akisema kwamba wale ambao waliingilia maandamano ya vijana wa Gen Z walikuwa hirelings na wanasiasa fulani fulani. When I was called by Mr. Gaido, I told him, tell them that is called hogwash. If you have evidence that any of the national leaders have been involved with Gen Z, do not hesitate. Tuko tayari, tukamate, tuone exactly what it is, what evidence you have. Atuogopi, we love this country. What has happened instead? Nina kijana ambaye anaishi Gachie. Aliona watu wa Gachie, a lot of them walikataa, lakini wengine wakapatiwa marungu na pesa. Pesa, kwendeni mukaribu maandamano ya amani ya Gen Z, vijana waonekane wao wamegeuka kuwa wahuni. This has been state sponsored terrorism. Kuharibu maandamano ya amani ya vijana.
Mr. President, it is very important to listen to people. It is very important to listen to people. We need these people. Na kuziweka chini, tusikie vile watu wetu wanasema ni kitu ya maana. It did not have to get to this. Lakini hapo tumefika, tunamwachia Mungu.
Tutulie ili tuanze rasmi. Comrade, tutulie. Oya, oya. Oya, oya. Na tumekuja tumekuja kwa mazishi ya Rex. Naomba jezi majezi wote tafadhali. Ile chini. Sifuna sekretari anasema tukae chini. Na umeona gavana pia ameingia. Na venye alisimama na sisi tukae chini. Asanteni.
Naomba tafadhali kweli kwa mlango tufungue hiyo familia.
Shell shot with the husband Chris and